We have an interconference affair lined up for you today as the Los Angeles Clippers come in for this one. Hi, everyone. We're happy to have you with us for this edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. I'm Kevin Harlan. We've got Steve Smith and Greg Anthony alongside, and our sideline reporter tonight, David Aldridge. You take a look at the 76ers. They're pretty rattled right now after a road trip in which they did not win a game. Now they hope to get back on track here at home.
And the start of a brief homestand for them, and they have a chance, Kevin, to get some wins in front of the home fans before they get back out on the road.
Steve, obviously every team wants to start a season strong. How do coaches and players create a sense of urgency early in the season?
I think it happens in preseason. It happens in the training camp where you're looking and saying, we have to get off to a good start. And a lot of times coaches are looking at their schedules. The back half of the schedules can be very tough.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of road games or a lot of playoff teams. That's why at the beginning you want to get off to a great start. And you got to send that message to your team and let them know the reason why. And I think a lot of times that's when players respond.
Well said. All fueled up and ready to go. Brought to you by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. Taking a look at Los Angeles. Harris and Gortat are up front. Bradley and Gallinari are the wingmen. And it's Beverly in at the one spot. Now Harris, after Markel Fultz missed from long range. And Gortat kicks to Gallinari. Rebounded by Covington. 76ers have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one so far. And just over a minute played here in the start of the game. Clock at 4. It's hauled in by Beverly.
And the fadeaway was the only option he had on that one. Defender there all over.
The tray. And the Clippers miss again.
Yeah, not a great shot there, especially when you got a lockdown defender guarding you.
You know, there's no shame in passing out in that situation. Leave your ego at the door.
Now here's Simmons. 11 points for him in that last game against Toronto.
You know what? I also like how he attacked the glass. Gave a terrific effort in that department.
Well, the Clippers looking to build their own arena in Los Angeles. Being the second or third tenant at Staples Center doesn't really feel right anymore.
Big plans are laid in Inglewood, adjacent to the new football stadium. Seems like it would be a win for the fans, the team, and the city.
Just an amazing feel for the game. Simmons is so gifted at reading the floor.
Beverly finds Gortat. Back to Beverly. Here's the three. Second shot opportunity. And there's the nice layup by Gortat. Gortat's got his first points of the game.
And where's the help? Obviously a missed rotation. Something they're going to want to patch up.
Only the first quarter. Guys are getting in a groove, but communication on the defense has to be better.
Now here's Brent. Harris looking it over. Los Angeles needs to get off a shot here. Bradley can't get it to go. And here's Šarić. He'll bring it up for the 76ers. Now here's Fultz. He's covered closely. And Embiid throws it down.
Yeah, his instincts are on display here. Fultz, a really good passer, excels at setting up teammates for easy looks.
Beverly against Simmons. And Beverly kicks to Gallinari. Back to Beverly. There's the three. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. Outplayed in the previous game on their schedule, losing to the Raptors.
No other way to put it. Defense was awful. Completely uninspired at that end of the floor.
They also committed a lot of mistakes while their opponent was extremely disciplined.
He kicks it to Harris. And he banks in the layup.
Nice bucket. The polished inside game. Something Harris relies on.
A good close contest so far as we finish the first quarter. 76ers ahead. They lead by a bucket. Live from Philadelphia, you're watching 2K Sports. A native of Cameroon, Joel Embiid talks about making a quick transition to the United States.
Not knowing English, obviously at the beginning, it was a little bit hard to like express myself. Obviously, I can speak English perfectly now, so that's a plus, and I'm just being myself.
And that unique sense of humor, Greg, is a specialty of Embiid's.
He's a fun-loving guy who's become a must-follow on social media. And the transition he's made has been remarkable.
Some good action already in this one, but a fairly even matchup after the first quarter of play. And looking at what we've seen from the 76ers, what do you guys think?
A huge fan of how they have rotated here defensively, been able to challenge multiple shots.
Yeah, it's been the defense that has them out in front. But let's see if they can sustain the intensity.
And the Clippers, looking at who they've got, we've got Mbamute, Gilgeous Alexander out there with Lou Williams. Then there's Marjanovic. And it's Harrell in at the power forward position. Some smaller players spend most of their time on the perimeter. Others really sacrifice, Steve, their bodies to make plays inside.
I think some of the small guys that get in there, like you said, is Kyrie Irving, one of the best at finishing. Kemba Walker, Mike Conley, Isaiah Thomas, Steph Curry. Some of these smaller guys who don't mind throwing their body into the paint.
McConnell kicks to Muscala. Back to McConnell. Philadelphia moving the ball around. The 76ers need to get off a shot. Redick for three, drills the three-pointer. Redick's got the lead, back up to five now for the 76ers. Redick against Williams. Again, Los Angeles.
That was big because they dug a big hole in the first quarter, but starting to show signs of life.
McConnell kicks to Redick. And he makes good on the layup. Redick's got 5 points now in the quarter.
And of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is just smash-mouth physical basketball, guys.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game.
And it was the screen there, guys, that freed him up as he ran his man into it.
And then it was all acceleration, GA, to the bucket right after that.
That was just a textbook pick that allowed him room, and he took advantage of it.
And the 76ers decide to take their first timeout here. And this is the first season matchup for them against this Clippers team.
Yeah, and they swept this matchup the two times they played last year. They held the advantage on paper and on the court.
But hey, it's a different season, and anything can happen.
And a brief check of the stats for Williams. A very nice season for him last year. He averaged 22 points per game last season, 5 assists and 2 rebounds. And to have a knockdown shooter like that coming off the bench, a great asset for any coach.
For sure. Things can get stagnant without that spark plug. He always seems to supply points for them in bunches.
Now here's Williams. 17 points for him last game against the Thunder in Oklahoma City.
And he really controlled the pace of the game by getting to the line. The D could not slow him down, and he took advantage of it.
Philadelphia leading by three.
Doc Rivers, the coach of the year in 2000 with the Orlando Magic. A championship with the Boston Celtics in 2008. A great career as an NBA coach.
Williams against Redick. That's in, and he's now 3 for 3 and looking sharp.
You have to be aware of JJ whenever it's a pick and roll. His movement off the screen is outstanding.
Pass to Gilgeous Alexander. A baseline J. That's good on the jump shot. Gilgeous Alexander's got 4 this quarter. And Doc Rivers came to the Clippers after he avoided a rebuild in Boston. But he's staying put in L.A. for the revamp.
A guiding voice for this team through some turbulent years. I think he's invested in making the Clippers a destination franchise.
Knocked away. 36 seconds left in the second quarter. Simmons with the defensive effort.
Fantastic rim protection. That's not in his wheelhouse to overcome.
Shamet guarded by Marjanovic. Simmons inside. Harrell on him. Ben Simmons gets the bucket. Simmons got the lead up to 5 now for the 76ers. Williams with the ball. Over in the corner, Mbamute. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. And some good action through the first two quarters as we reach halftime. 76ers lead by 5. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Kevin, thanks. Coach, what is your impression of the first half?
Did we play? And I thought we found a really good balance of posting and pace. It's what we've been talking about. And I thought our defense, for the most part, was excellent.
A good start. We'll see how they finish. Thanks, Coach. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hi again, everyone. I'm Ernie Johnson, sitting alongside the Diesel and the Jet. Welcome to the Halftime Show on 2K Sports. For the 76ers, the first quarter was pretty even. They did jump out to a lead in the opening period, but 4 points was the biggest it got. Taking a look at the 76ers, Kenny, what's your take?
Well, I like the effort on the boards. Because a game could come down to just a few key possessions, and extra rebounds can give you those extra possessions if you work at it.
Shaq, what was your takeaway on the Clippers?
Well, the low turnovers really stood out to me. They didn't get loose with it or make silly passes. Nothing was forced. They had a nice flow to the offense. Guys knew where to be on the floor. That's the heads-up style of play they need to bring in the second half.
And that does it for our halftime show. We now take you back to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third period.
And if you're just joining us, we've played through the first half in a game that's been fairly even so far. You look at J.J. Redick, what a contribution.
And they haven't needed a lot of shots to get their points. Just tremendous efficiency here in the first half.
What I love watching is they are working for high percentage looks and cashing in when they get them.
And in that first half, we saw a pretty tight battle. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during the half. Charge is the 4 with Embiid in the middle. Simmons and Fultz, the backcourt pairing. And it's Covington in at the 3. And that's the group for Brett Brown as we begin the second half. And Danilo Gallinari, a 6'10 small forward. Steve, good size for his position, obviously.
Yeah, one concern is on a defensive end. It's his foot speed. But on an offensive end, he uses that size to his advantage.
And here's Beverly following the 3-pointer from Dario Saric. Here's Bradley. Solid shot from the distance of about 14 feet. Bradley's got his first 2 points.
And this is what Avery likes. It's where he feels most comfortable, the in-between area.
Embiid, the pass to Simmons. Over Beverly. Poked away.
Yeah, nice effort there in tracking down the long rebound.
Bradley can't get it to go.
And that was an easy one there, just a missed opportunity.
If you give it to him, he'll take that shot every time down the floor. I'm sure he's kicking himself.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Beverly against Simmons. And Beverly kicks to Bradley. Shot clock at 5. For 3. Buries the long-range jumper. Bradley's got 5.
From out beyond the arc, Bradley getting more confident each year.
Pass to Simmons. Over Beverly. And the 76ers tack on 2 more.
He's been so consistent scoring the basketball. It has helped him tack on to this lead.
Gallinari outside. Smitty, there are a lot of funny guys that play in pro sports, and the NBA is no exception now and in the past. Who would you say is the funniest guy you ever played with?
Yeah, a couple guys, Kevin. There's some funny guys. I think one that stands out far as just being a straight comedian, had guys laughing, was Ken Norman. And I think there's another guy that was extremely funny, but he wasn't trying to be funny, was Dikembe Mutombo. Some of the things Dikembe would say and do, it was just hilarious. And he wasn't trying to be funny.
That's good, and the 76ers lead is cut down to 7 on the bucket from Harris. 76ers have gotten 4 of their first 5 second half shots to fall, 80% since the break. Embiid is at the elbow from the line. Here's Simmons. That's in. That's his 5th field goal. He's shooting a hot 71%, 5 for 7. Clippers trail by 9. Beverly finds Harris. 52 seconds left in the third. Gortat, the pass to Gallinari. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. George has got his 6th rebound on the night.
And they continue to control the glass. 2-for-1 territory, but they got to work quick.
This is where the play calling comes in. Let's see what they got.
Saric against Beverly. In the corner, Bradley with it. Over Fultz. That's good, and the 76ers' lead is cut down to 7 on the bucket from Bradley.
Explosiveness off the floor. Avery Bradley able to shoot over the contesting hand.
A nice shot by Embiid.
And because of his size, that's a difficult shot to contest.
But it's not just the size, it's the natural feel for the mid-range game. Not everyone has it.
And so it's Philadelphia, ahead by 9 as the quarter comes to a close. Their lead is where it is because they've gotten good shots. A lot of good shots. Back to the action after this word. And let's take this opportunity now to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call court vision.
Yeah, you also have the location of the pass. Puts it right where it needs to be, where his man can do something with it.
And this is it. Glad to have you along for this 4th and final quarter. And Simmons has got the ball here for Philadelphia. They lead by their biggest margin of the game, 9. And on the floor for the Clippers here in the 4th, Gallinari and Harris, your small and power forwards. Lou Williams out there with Gilgeous Alexander. And it's Marjanovic in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Here's Gilgeous Alexander. Back to Gallinari. And he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim. Gallinari's got the 4th quarter started here with a bucket for the Clippers. Right side, Simmons unloads from 13. No good, shot missing. And the Clippers will go the other way with it. When this game is done, they'll be off to Orlando and they'll take on the Magic. That'll be the 3rd game of this 3-game road trip. Left side, Harris. Another one falls for the Clippers.
And now you can see the D having problems stopping the mid-range jumper, just not really closing out as much as they need to.
Simmons left side finds the bottom of the bucket from 13 feet out, and the 76ers lead by 7.
And the variety that Simmons offers is huge. It's pretty much pick your poison with him.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander, and a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot 2 here.
Two shots.
First one falls for him. Robert Covington's checked in for the 76ers. And a switch here also for the Clippers. Harrell, he's checked in for Marjanovic. That one falls, so he hits both of them. The 76ers leading by five. And Simmons kicks to Covington. The pass to Embiid. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
And I'll bet his percentage is pretty high from that range.
Embiid's gotten three of his four shots to fall, hitting 75%. Williams scanning the floor. That one's rebounded by Embiid.
You know that's one he liked to have back. Point blank range, and he missed it.
Muscala misses. Clippers trail by seven. Passes it to Gallinari. And stolen by Simmons. Oh, and the jam by Ben Simmons.
How about the activity of Simmons mucking up passing lanes and making life difficult on the opposition? So good at getting steals.
And a great second look there. Another Unleash Chaos replay. Brought to you by the Under Armour Hover Havoc. And the Clippers call time here. They're behind by nine. 1:39 left in the fourth quarter. And now let's present our Jordan player of the game, Ben Simmons.
Sensational game for him in terms of shooting efficiency. He's taken nothing but high percentage shots. That's how he's managed to hit over 60% from the field. I mean, making just about everything he's looked at.
This is as good a game as we've seen him play. And this crowd can't get enough of it. When he explodes like this, it becomes a special atmosphere in here. And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, during the break, I listened in on Doc Rivers talking to the team. He said, guys, we need to play with pace, and that'll get us some early fast break opportunities. We're playing way too predictable right now.
Thank you, David. Out to the wing. And that's a foul called on Gallinari. That's his first foul. We've got 1:13 left in the game. Simmons on the wing. Just five on the clock. Sharich finds Embiid. And he can't extend the lead to double digits.
You know what? He tried to lay it in at the point of attack. Just too much defensive pressure on that play.
Gortat with the bounce pass. Harris inside, covered by Sharich. Gortat misses.
And forcing the miss there, he just knows how to pressure you defensively.
And also protecting the rim at all costs. I love the anticipation to affect the shot.
And they've earned this one, showing an ability to dominate in front of their home crowd.
You know, you feel on top of the world when it happens as a player, just the relationship you have with the fans.
And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. That one on Embiid.
And at the offensive end, Gortat probably doesn't get his due. He's got a lot of moves, and he can finish with either hand. And his work on the offensive glass is more than capable.
shooting two.
He drops the first one, and that brings them to within 10. Both free throws, good from Gortat. And Simmons has got the ball here for the 76ers. So the 76ers win it. Some good competition, but the hometown advantage and their ability to stay focused, I think, made the difference.
Yeah, and the first step in becoming a good team is your ability to win at home. And they really seem to revel in that opportunity. And this is what they came out to do.
And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.